Evolocumab is a PCSK9, proprotein convertase subtilisin kexin type 9, inhibitor antibody used as an adjunct to LDL cholesterol-reducing therapies, aiding in the prevention of cardiovascular events and cardiovascular revascularization procedures. In this video, let's find found. What is evolocumab? What is evolocumab used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking evolocumab? How does evolocumab work? How to use evolocumab? What is evolocumab? Evolocumab is a monoclonal antibody that is an immunotherapy medication for the treatment of hyperlipidemia. Evolocumab is a fully human monoclonal antibody that inhibits proprotein convertase subtilisin / kexin type 9. What is evolocumab used for? Evolocumab is indicated in adult patients with established cardiovascular disease to reduce the risk of myocardial infarction, stroke, and coronary revascularization. It is also indicated as an adjunct to diet, alone or in combination with other hypolipidemics, in adults with primary hyperlipidemia, and in pediatric patients greater than or equal to 10 years old with heterozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, to reduce LDL-C. In addition, it is indicated adjunctly to other hypolipidemic treatments in patients greater than or equal to 10 years old with homozygous hypercholesterolemia to reduce LDL-C. Side effects: runny nose, sore throat, symptoms of the common cold, flu or flu-like symptoms, back pain, high blood sugar levels, diabetes, redness, pain, or bruising at the injection site. Mechanism of action. Evolocumab is a human IgG monoclonal antibody which targets PCSK9, proprotein convertase subtilisin / kexin type 9. PCSK9 is a serine protease produced by the liver which binds LDL receptors and creates a complex to be targeted for lipid degradation. LDL receptors typically bind LDL cholesterol, bad cholesterol, for cellular reuptake, therefore the formation of these complexes with PCSK9 inhibits LDL receptor recycling to the cell surface, resulting in decreased cellular reuptake of LDL-C and increased levels of LDL-C in the plasma. Individuals with familial hypercholesterolemia often may have gain-of-function mutations in the PCSK9 molecules in their body, resulting in increased LDL-C plasma levels and a consequent cardiovascular risk. Evolocumab is able to bind both the normal PCSK9 and gain-of-function mutant D374Y. The exact mechanism of the binding has not been published, however the precursor molecule, MAB1, is indicative of the interaction. The MAB1 molecule binds on the catalytic site of PCSK9 next to the binding site for the LDL receptor and creates bonds and hydrophobic interactions, resulting in the steric inhibition of binding between PCSK9 and the LDL receptor. Because the formation of complexes between LDL receptor and PCSK9 are prevented, the internalized LDL receptors are less likely to be degraded by lysosomes and cycle to the surface of the cell to serve their function of removing LDL from the blood. Half-life. Not available. Dose. Prevention of cardiovascular events. Indicated to reduce the risk of myocardial infarction, stroke, and coronary revascularization. 140 mg SC Q2 weeks or 420 mg SC once monthly, based on patient preference for dosing frequency and injection volume. When switching dosage regimens, administer first dose of new regimen on the next scheduled date of the prior regimen. Primary hyperlipidemia. Adjunct to diet, alone or in combination with other lipid-lowering therapies, e.g., statins, for treatment of primary hyperlipidemia, including heterozygous familial hyperlipidemia, HeFH, to reduce LDL-C, 140 mg SC Q2 weeks or 420 mg SC once monthly. When switching dosage regimens, administer first dose of new regimen on the next scheduled date of the prior regimen. Homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia. indicated as an adjunct to other LDL-lowering therapies in patients with homozygous familial hypercholesterolemia, HoFH, to reduce LDL-C, 420 mg SC once monthly. May increase to 420 mg q/weeks if a clinically meaningful response not achieved in 12 weeks. Patients on lipidapheresis may initiate treatment with 420 mg q/2 weeks to correspond with apheresis schedule. Administer evolocumab after completing apheresis session. Safety advice. AUTGA pregnancy category B1, drugs, which have been taken by only a limited number of pregnant women and women of childbearing age, without an increase in the frequency of malformation or other direct or indirect harmful effects on the human fetus having been observed. Studies in animals have not shown evidence of an increased occurrence of fetal damage. That's all the information about evolocumab we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.